Hidden underground and in the walls, it's easy to take plumbing for granted. But imagine if your home had no clean water coming out of its faucet, and no way for human waste to get out. This is the daily reality faced in the island nation of Haiti. The mountainous country is the poorest in the Western Hemisphere. And after centuries of exploitation, Haiti has been left a country without infrastructure or proper sanitation systems.
More than half of the people living in Haiti do not have a private place to go to the bathroom. The impacts of people not having access to a toilet are twofold. It's about public health, and it's also about the environment.
National Geographic Explorer Dr. Sasha Kramer is an ecologist and co-founder of Soil, a nonprofit working to address this lack of sanitation.
When all of those human wastes end up in water supplies, which they generally do eventually, what that means is that the water people are using to drink, to bathe, to wash their clothes, to wash their dishes, basically has poop in it. And that is what is the primary cause of illness in children under five in Haiti and really in many parts of the world.
The root of Haiti's problems can be traced back to the 18th century, when what is now Haiti was a slave colony of France. A rebellion against this slavery resulted in a declaration of Haitian independence at the dawn of the 19th century. In 1825, under the threat of war, Haiti was forced to compensate France for its loss of enslaved Africans and land. This payment was not fully completed until 1947, at today's equivalent of over $20 billion.
That money that went to pay France is money that should have gone to build infrastructure in Haiti, to put in place public schools, to put in a sanitation system, a water system. And none of that happened. So it also means that Haiti was forced to take out loans just to pay back their debt to France, which means that since its inception as an independent nation, Haiti has never been a country free of debt. So I think that's one of the main reasons you see these differences between Haiti and other countries in the Western Hemisphere.
This historical financial turmoil has contributed to a variety of problems for the island nation. Dr. Kramer believes ecological sanitation, ecosan, can play a role in addressing some of these problems. When organic waste decays, its energy can be transformed into nutrient-rich compost that, when mixed with soil, promotes the growth of healthy plants and crops. Ecosan is the process through which human waste is turned into an endless supply of this nutrient-rich compost.
People have a small in-home toilet that basically has a 5-gallon bucket in it. Instead of flushing with water, which is such a valuable resource, we use some sort of a dry carbon cover material. So this would be some sort of agricultural waste that's otherwise not being used. And you cover it up, and then that keeps the smells from coming out, and it keeps the flies from coming in. And then those full buckets are transported to one of Soil's composting sites. Once we dump the waste, most of the work is done by naturally occurring soil microbes. We dump the poop into these bins. The microbes, when they get access to this wonderful environment, they start to reproduce. And as they reproduce and there's more and more of them, this waste starts to naturally heat up from their activity. To actually kill the pathogens that make people sick, the World Health Organization says you need to attain a temperature of at least 122 degrees Fahrenheit or 50 degrees Celsius for a minimum of 7 days. And after that time, even the toughest human pathogens will be killed at this temperature. After about 6 months, we have a finished product, which is just this beautiful, rich soil.
And so, in addition to providing improved sanitation, the end product is a valuable resource that provides the foundation for nutrient-rich crops and economic opportunity for under-resourced communities in Haiti.